Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. We really appreciate all of the support you've shown on the channel so far. Today we want to make a video to show you how basic economics is used in everyday life. Specifically, we're going to be looking at the economics behind what could possibly be the most popular seasonal menu item of all time. The marketing behind this fall beverage employs some subtle economic concepts that make customers feel like they simply need to get one this fall. That's right, we're looking at the economics of the Starbucks Pumpkin Spice Latte. Starbucks has been around for a while, with the first location opening its doors in Seattle's historic Pike Place Market back in 1971. Today, the chain has grown to one of the most popular coffee shops in the world, boasting over 32,000 stores in over 50 countries worldwide. And so the story goes that in 2003, a research and development team led by Director of Espresso Americas for Starbucks, Peter Dukes, assembled at the chain's Seattle headquarters, eating some pumpkin pie and washing it down with hot espressos. The team was trying to discover some new flavors, and that's exactly what they did. Something about the flavor combination held promise, and as it turns out, Duke's team concocted the first pumpkin spice latte with cinnamon, nutmeg, and clove, and notably, no pumpkin. Here's a little fun fact, the drink didn't actually contain real pumpkin until 2015. So in the fall of 2003, Starbucks first brought the beverage to 100 stores in Vancouver and Washington, D.C. to test the beverage out. Within a week, Starbucks knew they had struck gold with their new beverage. But that was 18 years ago. Why in the world is there still so much hype surrounding one jack-o'-lantern flavored drink? The answer? Some simple economics. One of the most important factors in the PSL's strong recurrence every year is the fact that it's what economists call scarce. What does this mean? Well, the drink is only available for a few months each year, from late August until early December. Obviously, this means you can't just walk into a Starbucks in mid-April and order a pumpkin spice latte because they simply aren't selling them. So now you only have this narrow window to buy the drink, and this classic limited time only approach is a great way to draw customers in to create a sense of urgency to buy a PSL while you still can. Here's the catch. Starbucks can produce this popular beverage all year round, so why don't they? Well, Starbucks intentionally restricts the annual supply of pumpkin spice lattes to increase the demand for it in the allotted 16-week availability window. This results in the drink being hyper-popular in the fall season, which means sales of the PSL are all but guaranteed to perform well in the future seasons. Just look at how it's trended year after year. Suppose they were available all year long. Suppose that at any point during the year, you could go into Starbucks and get a PSL. You wouldn't spend your summers eagerly awaiting the beloved PSL because you could go off on any random day of your choosing and get one. This would result in your demand for the good potentially decreasing, and Starbucks doesn't want that. Starbucks hasn't introduced a one-and-done fad, but rather a dynasty of PSL craving fans year after year. Some people even equate the arrival of this drink to the true arrival of the fall season. It's always anticipated by millions, and each year the sales show that this beverage isn't going anywhere. This year, the pumpkin spice latte and the pumpkin cream cold brew returned on Tuesday, August 24th, so literally just a couple days earlier than the time of recording this video. If you're a fan, you'd better hurry and get it while you still can, because as Starbucks says themselves, it's available in the US and Canada stores for a limited time while supplies last. So there it is, folks. It turns out that the recipe to success is to create a premium product, artificially restrict the supply on this product, and therefore, with a clever marketing team, drive seasonal demand through the roof. We know that a lot more goes into the success of the PSL, and this is definitely an economics oversimplification for entertainment and educational purposes. But for now, the next time you're waiting in a line at Starbucks, you'll know the clever economic tactics Starbucks has employed to get you there. As we say every week, remember that our channel is just getting started and there's lots of content to come. If you like this video and are excited to see more, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd love to see us cover in the future.
From all of us here at Think Econ, thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.